Well, thank you. My name is Maria Sundin, and I'm an astrophysicist. There are lots of connections between astrophysics and water. But today, I want to tell you about why the Earth has water at all, and that it's not so easy to find another planet if we should mess up this too badly. So I will talk about water on other planets in our solar system and the search for planets around other stars. Are there other terrestrial worlds out there? Are there other worlds like our planet? Well, the history of water is 13.7 billion years old. It started with a Big Bang. I'll have to talk very rapidly if I'm going to compress all this history into this talk, so I'll skip a few parts. Hydrogen has been around for a long time. Hydrogen is one of the components of water. The other component is oxygen. We breathe oxygen, and I don't know if you've thought so much about where the oxygen comes from, but oxygen is created in the interior of stars. And when the stars explode, this oxygen is spread into the universe. And on this picture, you see an exploding star. Several stars had to explode before our sun was created. And when a star is created, like our sun, this happened about 5 billion years ago, there's some extra debris gathering around the star that will form the planets. And since a few stars had exploded, this debris around what was to become the sun had some oxygen in it and lots of hydrogen. And these elements together are joined to form water. There's quite a lot of water in the universe, mostly in the form of ice. Liquid water is much more uncommon. In the early days of the Earth, the Earth was bombarded by comets. Comets are, you can describe them as dirty snowballs, more or less. I believe I've heard that about 10 times the amount of water in our oceans today was bombarded on the Earth very early in the history. We have some bigger planets in our solar system, Jupiter, Saturn. They are protecting us for the moment from lots of impacts. During the first 500 million years of the Earth's existence, it was bombarded continuously with comets. So the water was brought to us by comets and by outgassing of the material that the Earth was created from. So the water comes from space, and it has come from space in many ways, both in the material that the Earth was created from, but also it was bombarded by comets. So we have a very nice planet with liquid water, and that is because it's at the right distance from the sun, so it's warm enough, and we have an atmosphere. We have air that keeps a nice pressure on the planet so that we can have big oceans. That's not so easy to find. And we also believe that the possibility of having life is very highly connected to having liquid water. We don't know how life started on the Earth, but we know very much that life is very old. As soon as the planet calmed down, life started to exist here. And I can't tell you if there's other life out in the universe. If I ever happen to tell anybody that I'm an astronomer, the first question I get is there life out there? But what I hope we can do rather soon is to tell you something about, are there other Earth-like planets out there where the conditions are the same, where liquid water, the same elements that life on Earth are formed from, are they common or are we very rare with our planet? Looking at our neighbor Mars, it is today a cold, dry, desert planet. It's smaller than the Earth. But during the time that life arose on Earth, originated here, Mars was very different. It had a huge ocean on the northern hemisphere. It had an atmosphere. So conditions were rather similar on Mars and on the Earth. And perhaps life started on Mars as well. We don't know that as yet, but the conditions were very similar. And if we talk about life in the universe, people usually want a big spaceship landing right outside there so we can, you know, try to communicate and stuff. But I would almost be just as intrigued if I found a dead bacteria or something very small, lifelike on Mars, because that could give us the key to the question of whether life originates if you have a, if you have a place where the conditions are favorable. The reason why Mars has changed so much is that it's smaller than the Earth. The lesser gravity means that Mars has been unable to keep its atmosphere. So it's a very low pressure on the surface. If you were to pour out a glass of water on the surface of Mars, it would just evaporate instantly. But there has been lots of water there. And this picture shows an old river delta on Mars. So just imagine this neighbor planet. It has had oceans, it has had rivers. It's been a very different world. So worlds can change. This means that Mars is not a very good candidate, perhaps, for life today, because there's no liquid water on the surface, and there's no protecting ozone layer there. Perhaps there could be some very simple life forms below the surface. We might find out, or perhaps they are not there. But there's one place in our solar system where liquid water might exist that's not the Earth. And it's this small moon. The moon is called Europa. It's one of Jupiter's moons. And if you look at Europa, it looks like a big ice ball. And why would you have liquid water out in the outer regions of the solar system? Well, Jupiter has approximately 60 moons. We have one. And if you combine the gravity working on Europa from the big Jupiter, Jupiter is so much bigger than the Earth, and the 60 other moons, you have different forces. You have different forces acting on Europa all the time, heating it. There's one moon that's even closer to Jupiter. That's called Io, and it has constant volcanoes because there are so many forces acting on it. Europa is a little bit further from Jupiter, and it looks like a big ice ball with cracks in it. We have had a few probes out there taking pictures of the surface of Europa, and the people who are looking at the ice, they claim that Europa, the surface of Europa, it looks more like the Arctic than the Antarctic. And the difference, of course, there is that on the Arctic, at the North Pole, you have ice floating on water. If you look at the Antarctic, you have ice lying on a continent. And they say that Europa shows more features that looks like ice floating on water. So perhaps out on this small moon could be a very several kilometers thick crust of ice, but there may be a huge subsurface ocean there. And in that case, it's the only other place than the Earth in our solar system where you have liquid water. And the conditions are probably quite similar to the conditions very deep in our own oceans. You have some heat from the interior of the moon. It's dark, of course, but you have liquid water, you have carbon, all the other elements that life is formed from here on the Earth, and you have energy. So it's a very interesting place, and I hope that you will have the chance to learn more about it. Several expeditions to this moon are planned, and the first thing is to try to find out, is there an ocean there? And we'll see if somebody's swimming in it. Well, if we are to leave our own solar system, I hope we don't have to, actually. In about a billion years, the sun is constantly increasing its luminosity, its output, its power. So actually, in about a billion years, the Earth will be too hot to have liquid water. A billion years is a very long time. Human history is quite short, actually. Sometimes when you talk about astronomy, people think that, oh, we are so small and insignificant, just living on this very small planet, and you know, having to repress things and not thinking about it. But I believe we are quite remarkable. We have a very short history of science, of thinking like that. But we constantly keep asking ourselves those questions. Where do we come from? Why does everything look like it is? And what can we do? And what are those things shining up there? I don't say that we have all the answers as yet, but at least we know something about the 13.7 billion years of history of the universe, and we know quite a lot about our Earth, where it came from, why it looks like it does, and also a little bit into the future. I hope that mankind's future will be very long. I sincerely hope so. So we have at least a billion years to solve our problems, but I think it's important to start today, but then we have to travel outwards, perhaps to Mars, perhaps to Europa. But is there someplace else to go to? Well, in 1995, we started to find the first planets around other stars. This is not a photo, this is a drawing by an artist. We can't take any pictures of these other planets as yet. So finding planets around other stars is a fairly new kind of science. And about 1 year ago, we had discovered 500, which means that we can start to make some statistics. And the fun thing is that we found so many planets that nobody had ever said that there was going to be out there. And the question was really, could there be another Earth, or is this the only one? There are so many really strange things out there. Super Earths, hot Jupiters, ice giants. We are trying to keep up with the nomenclature right now. With new telescopes, during 2011, the number of discovered planets is now exceeding 2,000. And we are finally getting some reports on perhaps Earth-sized planets, at least. There actually seems to be quite a good chance of finding ocean planets or water worlds out there. That is, planets that has no continents, just very, very, very deep oceans. You have some variations of these. If you move them a little bit further from their star, you get big icy planets, ice giants. If you move them a little bit towards the stars, you get steam, some kind of sauna planets. So I just really want to impress upon you that the universe is always stranger than we can imagine, but it is a part of our thinking from a very long time. How common are we and our kind of planet? I mean, you are students, most of you. You can try to find out this. What's out there? And some of them might be Earth-like also. The problem is that they are very small compared to a star, so they are hard to find. We have some different methods of trying to find them. So far, the Earth-like planets are very few, but I believe that in 5 years, we will know very much more about these. And if we have to leave our home in a billion years, perhaps we will know where to go. Thank you. Thank you.